way to a higher class, I hope, and I hope you will come with me there.
Hello, my name is Javier Estrada. Today I'll be giving an informative speech about Nina Simone, the priestess of soul. Who here has heard about Nina Simone before today? Nobody? Great, okay. So, in an interview with New Internationalist magazine, conducted in 1997, Nina Simone said this about her life. I want to be remembered as a diva from beginning to end who never compromised what she felt about racism and how the world should be, and who, to the end of her days, consistently stayed the same. She lived such an interesting life. She went from a classically trained pianist to, in a way, a cabaret jazz singer. She was born Eunice Kathleen Wayman in 1933 to a businessman for a father and an ordained Methodist minister for a mother. She began playing piano at the age of 3, and she quickly became one with the instrument. And she performed hymns, she performed just beautiful gospel music for her mother's congregation every Sunday. And by the age of 5, she began studying classical music. When she graduated high school, Simone went on to study and train at the Juilliard School of Music. However, she was unable to complete her studies due to lack of funding. And after some time, she turned away from classical music, and she started playing American standards and blues and jazz. And in order to make money and to gain notoriety for her talents, Simone began playing at a nightclub in Atlantic City, New Jersey. However, the owner threatened to fire her after a couple days because he wanted her to be more entertaining to sing. So she turned her interest toward jazz, blues, folk music, and in 1957, she released her first album entitled Little Girl Blue, and she scored a top 20 hit with the track I Loves You Porgy. I want to take a moment for the audience to listen to a song entitled I Put a Spell on You. This song was originally composed, written, and performed by a man named Jealousy Screamin' Jay Hawkins. Enjoy. After some time, Miss Nina Simone, she became a civil rights activist. She who wrote and sang the soundtrack of the civil rights movement. She lived in a time and place where racism was rampant, where acts of violence toward her fellow man were fearfully commonplace. Simone used her voice, both in music and in her outspoken demeanor, to combat and to condemn all of the negativity, the hatred, just the complete awfulness that was happening during this time. She wrote and performed a song called Mississippi Goddamn, a fiery condemnation of systematic racism and just disgustingness that was the 1960s. This song was powerful, it was righteous, and this really came from her inner being. This song came in response to the cruel murder of 4 black children in a church fire in Birmingham, Alabama. And in 1963, a man by the name of Medgar Evers was killed in Jackson, Mississippi. Goddamn.
Alabama's got me so upset. Tennessee made me lose my rest. And everybody knows about Mississippi. Goddamn.
recommendation for this documentary called What Happened, Miss Nina Simone. You can view this on Netflix. And let me just say, there's so much to this person. She lived an extraordinary life. She did extraordinary things. And I highly recommend.
Tennessee made
Thank
me
you so
lose
much
my
for taking
rest.
The time
and everybody
to listen to
knows about
Nina Simone.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel.